ISUPK presents the Lord's 51st annual Passover. All I
ever wanted. This is crazy, y'all. We in the arena. Okay, I can't explain to you the level that is. Back in 1985, I came in Israelite school of UPK. There were 20 wooden chairs on the men's side. And those chairs weren't even filled up, less on the women's side. Now, we are at the arena. This place is going to be packed with the children of the Lord shouting in one word and one name to them all.
On Thursday, April 9th, 2020, at sundown, we're going to be holding the Lord's 51st annual Passover.
I ain't a people pleaser, I don't like people either. I don't care if your Nas or Jigga ain't wanna meet ya. Just give me my motherfucking check if we do a feature. Tell Michael Jordan he can keep his fucking sneakers. Walk inside your favorite church and just drop your preacher. Cause he ain't gonna drop the right shit that he should teach ya.
But what about Obama?
Nigga, I don't like him either. What has he done for us?
We're gonna be located at the Westchester County Center, 198 Central Ave. White Plains, New York, 10606.
Diamonds in the cars. They got million-dollar houses. Have you seen ours? See, we get mesmerized and fail to recognize that they don't sympathize.
$100 for all adults 17 and over. Kids are for free.
But they'll be sleeping in that same place when that semi.
Start sending in your funds today.
You understand? We're going to go to Proverbs 23 and 23. You understand? We the ISUPK. The Israelite School of Universal Practical Knowledge started out of 1 West 125th Street, Harlem, New York, under Commander Jenny Ahana. We are not affiliated with any Israelite group on the face of the planet Earth or any Christian organization on the face of the planet Earth. The ISUPK is the home of the truth since 1969, bringing out the truth according to the Bible to all blacks, natives, and Hispanics, man. You understand? It's about time that we start bringing out the truth and telling black people who the devil is that walks the face of the earth, man. You understand? It's about time that black people receive some truth and some honest guidance, and you understand it not, and stop being strangled by the Christian church, man. You understand? For hundreds of years, blacks and Hispanics, the condition that blacks and Hispanics have been in, have been mocked, that have been overlooked, and have been laughed at, man. We bring out the conditions that black people are going through, and it seems like we sound crazy. And it seems like hate speech, right? It seems like hate speech when the real hate speech is coming from the Christian church that don't want to see the oppression of black people being let up, man. You understand? I mean, all this talk about Trump and World War III this and World War III that, when black people been going through war for over 300, 400 plus years, man. And who's talking about it, man? Nobody in the Sunday churches talk about the oppression that's going on with black people. Nobody's talking about it, man. You understand? But we gonna bring it out, man. We gonna tell you exactly what you should do, man. And right now, black man, you should not be looking to go and listen to white man's military, man. You understand? We've been going through war every single day. You don't see no FEMA in our neighborhoods, man. You don't see no FEMA organization in Southeast, in Northeast, in Chicago, in Philly, in Cali. You don't see no FEMA over there. You understand? Ain't nobody coming to our aid, so what are we doing fighting in America's wars, man? Let America and the white man have that smoke that he been asking for, man. But there's something that we should do right now, man. You understand? There's something that we should tighten up within our own households, man. You understand? There's something that we should do. Don't go enlist in the white man's military, man. You understand? We got a recruitment office right here. He go to recruitment office right here. Grab your flyer. Commander General Honor been looking for a soldier. And better yet, the Most High God of Israel been looking for a soldier. Here go your recruitment office right here, man. Come grab your flyer, man. You got that Proverbs 23 and 23, man. Let him know you up.
Proverbs chapter 23 and 23. Buy the truth and sell it not.
Hold on, black man. You understand? The truth according to this Bible, you understand, has been made docile by the Christian church, man. Black people have been strangled by the Christian church, man. You understand? The scripture said, by what? By what?
By the truth.
By the truth, man. You understand? You understand? Don't go buy that weed. Don't go buy and invest into the white man's stripper clubs. Don't go buy and sell your soul at the same time, man. With the scriptures, invest in the truth, man. Invest in something that's gonna change your life. Buy something that's gonna get our children off of drugs. Buy something that's gonna get our daughters off the stripper pole. Buy something that's gonna get some righteousness within the black community and Hispanic community, man. Read it from the top.
Buy the truth and sell it not.
And sell it not. That sounds something beautiful right there, man. The truth sounds mighty sweet to me. The scripture said, buy the truth and sell it not. In other words, it's priceless, man. In other words, it's priceless. Something that's priceless that's only for us, I need that. That's how absolutely sweet. Read it from the top one more time.
Buy the truth and sell it not.
Buy the truth and sell it not. You can't sell the truth, man. Why? Because the truth is something that has no price on it, man. You understand? Some white cop kill your child. You understand? No amount of money that they can pay you, man, that's gonna replace that, man. Ain't no amount of nothing that they can give you that's gonna bring back your child, man. You understand? But it said to buy the truth and sell it not, man. Invest into the truth and don't you ever sell it in your life, man. Because your children and my children need it, man. Read on.
Also wisdom and instruction.
Also wisdom and instruction, man. You understand? We gotta understand what our wisdom and our instruction is, right? Hold that, give me Deuteronomy 4 and 6. We gotta understand what our wisdom is, because everybody walking around think they got some wisdom. When according to the Bible, the law, statutes, and commandment is our wisdom. You understand what I'm saying? You got that? No sweat. Read.
Deuteronomy chapter 4.
This our wisdom right here, man. This is what you want to know, what you want to teach your children and how to raise your children? Read.
Deuteronomy chapter 4 and 6. Keep therefore and do them.
Keep therefore and do them. Go ahead.
For this is your wisdom.
For this is your what?
This is your wisdom.
Your what?
Your wisdom.
Your what?
Wisdom.
For this is your wisdom. Read it from the top.
Keep therefore and do them.
Keep therefore and do them. Go ahead.
For this is your wisdom.
This is not an option. This is your wisdom. Read it again.
Keep therefore and do them. For this is your wisdom and your understanding in the sight of the nations, which shall hear all these statutes and saying, surely this great nation is a wise and understanding people.
And when we follow this wisdom right here, every nation will look at us and they'll be like, God damn. God, who is teaching them? Who is teaching them? They're the best thing on the earth. They got some class. They got some respect for themselves when we follow this wisdom. Take me back. Take me back, man. You understand? We gotta come back to the truth of this Bible, man. That's what we should do in this time right here, man. Read it again from the top.
It's Proverbs chapter 23 and 23. Buy the truth and sell it not.
Buy the truth and sell it not, man. The truth is not something that you can just let go, man. If it means something so dear to you. If you care about your brother and your sister. If you care about your wife. If you care about your children. If you care about the 400 years that America has put us in. And this entire world has put us in. You're going to care about the wisdom that's in these scriptures, man. Because it's going to save a life, man. It's going to save a brother's life who's being oppressed. You understand? Tatiana Jefferson didn't know this, man, because her Christian pastor didn't teach her, man. Both of them, John didn't know this because her Christian pastor didn't teach her that the white man is the devil that the Bible speaks of, man.
Damn right.
You understand? Drop that. Give me Psalms 119 and 72, because we're going to keep bringing it out, man. The Christianity and Christian church is garbage, man. You understand? Buy the truth and sell it not, man. What you can sell, you can go sell that Quran. Throw it in the garbage. What you going to sell, you can go sell that drug right to the garbage, man, because that's exactly what belongs, and that's because that's exactly what it is, man. You got that? Psalms 119 and 72. You got that? Read.
Psalms 119 and 72. The law of thy mouth is better unto me than thousands of gold and silver.
There go another one. The law of thy mouth is better than me than gold and silver. In other words, what I think is my fortune, the law is better for it. It's better for me. Why is the scripture saying, why is he saying it's better for him? Why? Why is he saying we know the profit and the eyes and the gloomy eyes that we get for when we get a nice green dollar or when we get a check, right? But read it again.
The law of thy mouth is better unto me than thousands of gold and silver.
Than thousands of gold and silver. The law is better than me. Black man, the law is the best thing that you can get, man. The law, statute, commandment in this Bible that was written by black men is the best thing that you can get, man. And on top of that, the priests and prophets of the Lord that are going to bring the truth to you, man.
That's right.
Straight up and down, man.
That's
it's
right.
Our time that we stop listening to these Christian pastors and these so-called wannabe revolutionary rappers, man.
Damn right.
You understand? God ordains who's going to teach his word, man. You can't just wake up one day and just say, oh, I thank God this and I thank God that. A brother said it the other day that's in the ICBK, and he said it so beautifully, man. He said it so beautifully. When you honestly believe in God is when you sit there and say, I don't determine what's right or wrong, man. The Most High determines what's right or wrong, man, not you. You understand? Read it from the top.
It says,
The law of thy mouth is better unto me than thousands of gold and silver.
Good night. It's better for me. And this is what's best for you. The law is priceless, man. You can't just sell it, man. You gotta buy and invest into that, man. Drop that, give me Proverbs 16 and 16. Cause we gonna bring it all the way out, man. You understand? All this talking about the World War III and whatnot, right now we got a way that we gotta focus on something, man.
Damn right.
You understand? Read. Proverbs 16 and 16. Go ahead.
This is Proverbs chapter 16 and 16. How much better is it to get wisdom than gold?
Whoa, read that again.
How much better is it to get wisdom than gold?
One more time. I need to hear myself one more time. Go ahead.
How much better is it to get wisdom than gold?
How much better is it to get wisdom than gold? The book of Deuteronomy chapter 4 verse 6 just told us what wisdom was. And the brother said, how much better is it to get that wisdom other than gold?
Damn right.
How much better is it to get the law, statute, commandment than gold? That's a beautiful thing, man. That's priceless. Our law, statute, commandment is better than gold. Damn the white man's laws are worse than gold. They're worse than garbage, man. Do you understand? They're worse than garbage. So I ask you again, what are we doing? You understand? Buy the truth and sell America's culture. We don't want it. You understand? We don't want it. Read.
ISUPK presents the Lord's 51st annual Passover.
Yo, this is crazy, yo. We in the arena. Okay, I can't explain to you the level that is. Back in 1985, I came into Israelite School of UPK. There were 20 wooden chairs on the men's side. And those chairs weren't even filled up. Less on the women's side. Now, we are at the arena. This place is going to be packed with the children of the Lord shouting in one word and one name to them all.
On Thursday, April 9th, 2020, at sundown, we're going to be holding the Lord's 51st annual Passover.
I ain't a people pleaser. I don't like people either. I don't care if your Nas or Jigga ain't wanna meet ya. Just give me my motherfucking check if we do a feature. Tell Michael Jordan he can keep his fucking sneakers. Walk inside your favorite church and just drop your preacher. Cause he ain't gonna drop the right shit that he should teach ya.
But what about Obama?
Nigga, I don't like him either. What has he done for us?
We're gonna be located at the Westchester County Center, 198 Central Ave. White Plains, New York, 10606.
Diamonds in the cars. They got million-dollar houses. Have you seen ours? See, we get mesmerized and fail to recognize that they don't sympathize.
$100 for all adults 17 and over. Kids are for free.
But they'll be sleeping in that same place when that semi.
Start sending in your funds today. For booking information, check us out on the ISUPA 51st Annual Passover Facebook page. More updates will be available soon. Last but not least, Israel, Commander General Yohanan will be accepting the men willing to stand for the Hebrew Academy 2021. If you a black, Hispanic, or Native American Indian male, and you want to participate in Hebrew Academy 2021, contact the nearest camp leader in your city to see if you got what it takes to be a soldier in the Army of Christ under Commanding General Yohanan. ISUPK presents the Lord's 51st Annual Passover.